Is it possible then, I mean, let's move from that stage, that the owners of MT Grace, whom you suspected had dealings, are you saying in clear terms that you suspect that the owners of MT Grace vessel had dealings with the owners of Integrated Oil, and that Integrated Oil, the owners, were quite aware of where the product was coming from? And it wasn't just a case of we rented our tank farms out to anybody who wanted to store, but they also had to be able to verify where the product was coming from.
Let me tell you, for the records, as we speak, the owners of MT Grace are on the run. That is a statement of fact. And then we're not here to pass judgment on Integrated Oil. What we did was what we were supposed to do within the ambits of the law. We traced a stolen cargo to Integrated Oil. Our take on it is that automatically Integrated Oil becomes part of the investigation process. At the end of the day, if the agency of government that is empowered to conduct investigations clear them, we're okay. Nobody has controverted the fact that the stolen cargo was found in Integrated Oil. And we're saying that it's a chain. You don't stop at the small boys who do the hijacking. We have said it emphatically. We're telling the Nigerian public that NIMASA is bent on tracking these people down because it borders on economic sabotage. Nigeria's image is at stake here. And we're telling whoever is involved that the game is up. We don't want to turn Nigeria into Somalia. These are the things that if you don't nip it in the bud, it has the capacity to assume a very worrisome dimension.
You know, since this same vessel is on the run, and well, we thought, tell us what NIMASA does. We'll come back to this whole issue about Integrated Oil, because if this was actually hijacked, we thought NIMASA had its eyes on the sea, on our waters, so that things like this wouldn't have happened in the first place. Now we're talking about safety issues here.
Yes. You know, by the very nature of our waterways, it's a complicated terrain, very complicated. But, you know, let's not just begin to look at it from the safety aspect of it. There are other things that NIMASA does. Because we're seeing the maritime sector as a huge sector. It is capable of generating massive employment for our teeming youths. Government is focusing on that. And there are so many programs of NIMASA that are channeled towards capacity development, human capacity development, even infrastructural. We have an ongoing program that deals with seafarers. The program is designed principally to train our youths in seafaring for purposes of securing jobs for them internationally. And you know their payments, it's dollar denominated.
What I want us to look at, do we have armed people from NIMASA watching over what is happening there? So that, because if otherwise, this is just one story coming to us about a hijack, and finally bathing here in the country and the product coming into the country, if that is what you just painted for us. And if we don't have our eyes on our seawaters, on our waterways, rather, I don't think that this will just be the last of it.
You know, statutorily, we are not empowered to carry arms, but we are working in collaboration with the security agencies. The Navy, there's a joint patrol, the Navy and other agencies of government. The case of Iheanacho, because we heard that he said on air that his premises was invaded.
And has been taken over, he said, as well as his vessel on the sea.
But the point is, NIMASA is a responsible agency. We couldn't have done that. Honestly, we have tremendous respect, profound respect for Oyanacha, because not only is he a former minister of the Federal Republic, he is a major stakeholder, a captain of this industry. And I want to let you know that he is instrumental to the enactment of the Cabotage Act. So, but what we're saying is this. We have to do our job. And when we went to the premises of Iheanacho, Captain Iheanacho, we couldn't have arrested him like a common criminal. He drove in his car to the premises of Nimasa. We gave him all the respect he's entitled to. So this blackmail, I'll call it a blackmail, you know, you don't come and say that an agency as responsible as Nimasa can invade a premises. It's not possible.
Okay, we'll listen to some of what he said while he was here, so that perhaps you could just get some more perspective on that. So let's see that now.
We know the vessel, we know the owner of the vessel. The owner of the vessel is actually somebody that is well known to the chaps at Nimasa. So there was no question as to whether one ship or the other brought it. The important thing is this. If you say that you are tracing oil that you suspected to have been stolen, and you trace it through the Ports Authority, and Ports Authority have issued their permission for this vessel to come into port. I mean, if you have any questions, the first thing that you would want to do is to go and arrest the managing director of the Ports Authority. Then you trace it to the Navy, who issued the permission for this cargo to come into port. If you have any questions as to that, you probably would have to go and arrest the Chief of Naval Staff. Then you go on to the DPR and do the same thing. Then you go on to the Director General of Nimasa. But none of this was done. They simply came to our tank farm and ransacked and rummaged it, seized our people, really, really assaulted them, locked them up for days in the SSL facility in Lagos here, and then subsequently on the following day, they carried on the plan and came not to get an official who would give clarification in respect of any questions that they had, but to pick up specifically myself and to situate me in this embarrassing context and create this impression that Captain Iheanacho, 60 years old, all the things that I've done in my life, that what I'm now doing is breaking into oil pipelines and stealing products. What would I want to do that for? I've achieved almost everything I want to achieve in life, and I have no call whatsoever to deviate from the path of distinction that I have set for myself in life. I know that so many things have been happening to my company, which lead me to believe that absolutely something is really amiss. And this other incident that happened over the weekend completely confirms it to us. We haven't been receiving allocations as other tank farms. We have been underselling. That's why we put our tank farms out and rent them to people who have products to put through the tank farm. So I'm not entirely what the issue is. It seems to me that somebody is targeting our business, trying to destroy us, and now I'm absolutely frightened for my own personal security.
Well, there you have it, and the chain of arrest. As a matter of fact, what do you think about all what he said?
Just a simple question. A simple question. And it needs very simple answer. Did we trace the stolen cargo to Integrated Oil?